As someone who loves the face tagging features in photos, and was particularly excited when pets were added last year, I've also been wanting one extra feature, and that is the ability to group people together in automatic albums. Well, in iOS 18, as part of the Photos app redesign, there's now the ability to create automatic groups of faces. Your phone will start doing this automatically for you by working out people that commonly go together, but you can also fine-tune and customise this process yourself. So in the Photos app, you'll see that I've scrolled down to the People and Pet section, and when I tap onto here, at the top there's a new section called Groups. You may have some here automatically, but for me, I'm going to press Create at the top there. From here, I can then select any people or pets that I've tagged in my photos to create that automatic group. To begin with, I'll choose myself and my wife, so I'm going to tap onto me and tap onto Safi. And then when I press Create, I can give it a name if I wanted to. I'll keep it as Jacob and Safi. And then you'll see straight away that Photos has pulled together all of the pictures that both of us appear in together. This will automatically update over time as more pictures are taken, and Photos will use its AI skills to try and find the best cover pictures to highlight on the album for you. Of course, you can add more than one group of people together, and to demo this, I'll add one last group of myself and my two cats. So I'll go back to where I was just now and I'll press Create, and on that list of people I'm going to tap onto myself, but also Polly and Pudding. Photos has recognised those cats over the last year, and so when I press Create, I'll get a group of pictures of the three of us. And as you can see, there are now some pictures of me with both of my cats, including this rather bizarre one, where they decided to squash me and keep me there for a good 20 minutes. This is one of the features in iOS 18 which is really, really helpful, and in fact, I love this feature. But it's one that's gone under the radar a little bit. It's not one of the all-singing, all-dancing new features that you've probably heard about already, like icon tinting and dark mode icons. I spent the summer exploring iOS 18, and I reckon I found 100 different things that make your phone better than it was before. And so I'm really excited to share with you my 100 quick tips for iOS 18. Of course, just like normal, they're all on my YouTube channel down below, so you can get all 100 quick tip videos there. Or, if you'd rather a written format, I've made an ebook this year called 100 Quick Tips for iOS 18. It's friendly, it's easy to read, and there are screenshots and illustrations to help you make the most of your phone. So, I'd encourage you to check it out, and I'll see you guys next time.